Today we will talk about algorithmic thinking, the only part of computer science that is used in every single programming language and which is one of the most important things when it comes to solving a problem. However, it is not really mentioned in tutorials, blogspots or even university courses. Algorithmic way of thinking is the art of solving a problem with a step-by-step process, in such a way that a computer can efficiently carry out the task. So essentially, it is the process that you follow when you try to build a program. Normally, you just start with the first thing that pops up to your head and try to build it from scratch. Don't get me wrong, this can actually work. This is more suitable with a simple program, and even then, if you give it time, you can find some far better solution. But we will talk more about this in another video. The computational thinking applies to everything. For example, if you can't solve a problem even though you know the programming language. As I already told you numerous times, a programming language consists of four main lines of code. With that in mind, the only thing that separates a good programming from a bad one is how these command lines are used. If you start thinking about a problem, even the simplest one, you will understand that there are more than one ways to get the final output. For that, you will use the four command lines in different ways in order to achieve different results. Let's try to simplify the process. First, we should try to understand the problem, identify how it works and find the hidden parts. Then it is time for brainstorming. Start drawing arrays, data flows and in general doing everything in order to collect different ideas. Then you can start a theoretical evaluation of these ideas. Of course, this is not always correct or accurate, but it can give you a basic course to follow. Then choose the best idea, which is the core idea of your project. Finally, of course, we have to build the algorithm or the platform in general and evaluate the results. Between the previous two steps, you need to always remember that it is possible to have other ideas or to find that something is not easy to build or it is not viable. So keep handy the initial ideas and don't hesitate to write more ideas during the development of the current one. It is more than possible scenario to finish a development and decide that you need to develop a different version of this algorithm because the results are not good enough or for comparison reasons, so keep that in mind. Of course, in every one of these steps there are many more details and differences from this general model that we can't cover in one video, so we will probably create another one. Until now, you already understand why it is important to start developing your algorithmic way of thinking. It is something that can be used in every programming language and in fact in any real-world problem. It can help you create substantially better results and all that with a step-by-step process that will help you not only achieve the best possible results, but will also help you to put the right order in the process of making projects, which is really important if you want to scale up your skills.